Welcome back! In today's video, we'll be looking at how to fix apps, programs, and games that will not open on a Windows 10 PC or laptop. The methods in this video will be generic, which means they should work for whatever type of app, program, or game you are trying to open. In some very specific cases, the issue could be caused by something that we won't be able to fix, however, the methods should help in most cases. Feel free to skip any of the methods you know won't work or those that you have tried already. Remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe if the video helps. Let's get into the methods. The first method is just something to check and consider. Make sure that your PC is capable of running the software or program you want to open. If you have opened the program in the past, then you don't need to worry about this one. But if you haven't, just check that it is built for your PC. For example, it could be for macOS instead of Windows or for a different Windows version. Your PC hardware may also limit the ability to open and run certain apps, so check if your system meets the minimum requirements. The next method is to simply look for any error codes that are displayed when you try to open it. If there is an error code shown, you are much more likely to fix the issue by researching this exact code, as chances are other people will have had it in the past too. If there is no error code or no information given, we'll move on to some more methods. Up next, we're going to try ending the task in the Task Manager. It is quite common for some apps to not open fully and only open as background processes. Ending the task in the Task Manager will reset the app and it hopefully won't do this again. To end the task, open up the Task Manager by right-clicking on the taskbar and then by choosing Task Manager from the list. When the Task Manager opens, look down the list for the app you are trying to open. It might be under the Background Processes section. If you find it, right-click on it once and then choose End Task. Now try opening it again and it will hopefully work this time. If you don't see the app in the Task Manager at all, we can still continue with some other possible fixes. The next method is to try running the app or program as an administrator. Some apps may need to be run like this in order to open and work properly. Find the app you want to open, and right-click on it and select Run as Administrator. See if this works. If not, we'll move on to the next method. Next, try and update the app if you can. You will most likely need to do this through the store you downloaded the app from, for example the Windows Store or Steam. Updates should also be available to download and install from the app or program's own site. So check on there to see if there are any available. Next, think about any changes you have made that could have caused the app to stop working. This could be any settings changes, whether they were in the app or in Windows. For example, you may have installed some new software that could be interfering with the app and causing problems. This would be a potentially common occurrence with games and mods as an example. All you need to do is revert any settings changes you made or uninstall any apps that you installed at the time the problem started appearing. Please note that you only need to do this if you are confident that the changes affected the app. If you aren't sure, I would recommend just continuing with the methods in this video. The next method is to try a system restart if you haven't done this already. A restart could help refresh a lot of the settings on your PC and it could help fix the problem. It's up to you if you want to try this now or at the end of the video, but if you do restart now, when you return to the video, we'll have a few more solutions to try, where hopefully at least one of them will work. We're now going to focus on Windows updates. Firstly, if you know that a Windows update caused this problem, then click the card on screen now to watch my video showing you how to uninstall a recent Windows update. You only need to do that if you are 100% sure that the update caused the problem. If a recent Windows update didn't cause it, then it might be worth checking for and installing any new Windows updates. To check for Windows updates, go to the Settings page first by clicking on the cog icon within the Start menu. In Settings, choose Update and Security. Now check for and install any updates on this page. If for some reason your PC won't update, then click the card now to go to my video showing you how to fix this and update Windows. Let's move on to the next method. The next method will focus on just Windows apps, so if your app isn't from the Windows App Store, you can skip this. We'll try using the Windows Apps Troubleshooter first. To do this, search Troubleshoot in the search bar, and then click on the option called Troubleshoot Settings. In here, click on the blue link called Additional Troubleshooters. Scroll down to the bottom and there should be a troubleshooter called Windows Store Apps. Run that and see what it says. It might recommend some actions to take. The second to last method is to repair the app. I've left this one towards the end as it will be changing some of the files of the app or program. Before doing it, I would recommend backing up some of the files within the app, such as game saves or project files, if they are stored within the app's main folder. Search for the app's main folder on your PC and copy and paste any files you know contain information you want to keep. Paste these somewhere safe on your PC. You will definitely want to do this before moving on to the final method as well. To repair an app, first go to the control panel. You can get there by searching for it in the search bar. In the control panel, click on the blue uninstall a program link. This link is under the green programs section. You should now see a list of all of the programs on your PC. You won't be able to repair all of them, as some don't offer this option, but to check, find the app that isn't loading or working and right-click on it. If there is an option to repair, it should say repair in the list of options that loads. If the option isn't available, it might say change, which could be a similar option. Whichever you choose, each app will be different, but just follow the steps it provides and remember to back up anything in the files. The final method is to completely uninstall the app. After doing this, you should be able to just install it again like you did the first time. Remember to back up any settings, saves, and files that are within the app's main folder, otherwise they will likely be deleted. To uninstall an app in Windows 10, you need to go back to the place where we tried to repair apps. If you've closed it, the method was Control Panel, then uninstall a program from the Programs section. This time, find the app and right-click on it, and select Uninstall. Follow the steps and allow it to uninstall. After this, reinstall it again and hopefully this will have fixed the problem. Unfortunately, those are all of the methods I have. If after trying all of these it still isn't loading, it's likely that it is a very specific and unusual cause. The best place I would recommend further researching is on any forums relating to the app or game. Someone in there will know more about the exact app or program and should have more fixes. As always, I will keep the description updated with any new solutions I find, and if any of you find a fix in the future, then it would be great if you could return to the video and post it in the comments to help others. Click the card on screen now to watch a video of mine showing you 10 easy ways you can speed up your Windows 10 PC. Help support the channel by visiting the store, the link is in the description and at the end of the video. If you have any questions, then let me know in the comments below, and if you did find today's video helpful, remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe for more tips in the future. Be sure to stick around to see some of my other videos that you might be interested in. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in another video.